and disadvantages. Now we'll go to discuss the normal tamper-proof tags. Tamper-proof tags, ear tags, allow each animal to be uniquely identified with a pair of cost effective tags that can only be removed if the tag is cut out of the ear within a knife, with a knife. Like branding or any other methods of identification, the insertion or removal of the tamper-proof tag must be backed by a law. The law should require that all animals have a tamper-proof tag for identification. Tamper-proof tags also bearing the same number as usually attached to the to both ear tags or ears, actually using a special applicator. If one of the tags is accidentally torn out, then the livestock owner must be request a new tag that would have the same number from the competent authority. So, all of us used to use the ear tags in general. In Jordan, it's widely used. Also, our LITS program that belongs to the Ministry of Agriculture uses specific ear tags for all animals, farm animals actually in Jordan. And they can be used also, but we do need to fix them in both ears. Just only if accidentally one of them is lost, you can take the another, and you do need to know the exact number. So it can be also repeated. But in case you know the same animal number, if we lost both of them and you have a lot of animals in your herd, no one can predict the tag number that has been lost, and especially when you lost more than two animals, ear tags. If one just only lost, you can be predicted because you can go back to the flock or to the herd and screen all the animals. Just take all the animals' ear tags, and the one who lost this number will be known after screening all the animals and counting the animals, taking all the tag numbers. It's a very important thing, and the tags can be also found in different forms and different procedures to be applicated in the ear tags, and also in the by using several actually applicators functioning the ear tag. And we have a certain, and you know, it has certain procedure for tagging the animals by using the applicators. The first tag is flagged so that the identification of the animal is easily visible, while the second tag is usually the size of a 25 mm coin that is very difficult to remove. It's a very small one. One is large and the other is very small, just only to avoid removing it or losing it. Large flags tags are more visible, but are also easier to lose if the tag is engaged in a bush whilst an animal is grazing. The retention rate for the tags is usually over 99%. This procedure is widely used. Actually, they have two tags. One is visible, very very large, because you can identify the tag number from long distance from the animal. And the second one is like a coin, 25 millimeter in a surface area. It's like a coin, very small. And this small one is difficult, too difficult for it to be removed from the animal. This is another procedure to save them from losing the tags from the ears of the animals. Tags are numbered with an eye zone number that will have a country of origin digit. We return back to the how can we number the animal. It's an eye zone number, country origin digit. When working with a national database, no tags in the world should be duplicated. No tag should be duplicated. Lost tags will have the same number, but a smaller subscript number will identify that the tag is duplicate. All animal tags, number, and owner details must be registered in the database. Again, you do need, if you have the ability to manage any herd, whether it is sheep or goat or cattle or anything, okay? You do need to be sure that there is no a duplicate number in your herd or flock. This is very important thing, because if you have a duplicate one, you will not be able to identify which one is the best, which one is the worst, which one will be lost, which one is mortal, is will die, which one will be killed according to the skills. If you have a large number of animals, it will be a very, very, very difficult obstacle that cannot be solved. So you do need to be give them a unique tags, unique numbers actually, with certain digits to identify the individual or identify the individual from each other. You do need to know them, and also to identify the origin of those animals, the country, and also the city that belongs to, and finally the country in general, to identify, and also to identify them from the other databases, because if you are dealing with a huge database that belongs to so many countries or so many cities or governments, okay, you do need to use a unique numbers that can be differentiate the animals that belongs to several or certain region or certain city or certain village or etc. So it's very important to use an ISO number, unique numbers, without duplication, without duplication. As you see from this picture, this is the ear tag, this is the visual one, the large one. As you see, it is contained with several numbers, and also the small one, the coin 25 millimeter. The list system using tamper-proof tags will only work if all animals' movement and termination date are properly recorded at the competent authority designated for the task. Normal tags are adequate for systems starting out in identification and are successfully used in countries such as Zimbabwe, South Africa, with cell phone. Now you can see this thing is very important. With cell phone technology, individual owner identification could be verified against the national database, just only by using the cellular phone. The biggest disadvantages of using the normal tags, okay, is that it is labor intensive, and also the recording is prone to errors. Okay, those are the tags, as you see, the large visual one, visible one, and also the small that cannot be removed or cut out from the ear. You can see them, and those numbers, as you see here, those numbers 102098, those are digit numbers. They have a certain meaning. For example, the first two, the second two, the last two digits they put them for a certain purpose, not randomly. They can be also analyzed just only to find them which country those animals are belong, which city, which governorate, for example, and also which owner, or if you go back, which village. So those are the most important thing, and these are the main thing for the electronic farming. If you don't have ear tags, nothing can be obtained from the e-farming system. So I concentrate on the ear tagging system just only to understand this is a very, very important technique. Now, as we discussed previously with the irons, we do need to understand or to know the advantages, disadvantages, and solve the outcomes from the ear tag. The advantages: each animal is individually numbered with a barcode tag. Disadvantage: the barcode tag is impractical in extensive dry African conditions, and also it is also, if you go, for example, to work in another country, you do need to know the system, production systems, and also whether those tags are usually used and can be used with different. Barcode tag can be effective if backed by legislation, but the readability in a dry dust condition is questionable right here, because the tags can be electronic also as a barcode reading. advantage also ownership of each animal recorded in a central database, but also it requires administrative input to run the system. As a outcome, animal ownership is secure if a proper database is used. The barcodes of tamper-proof tags readers are more cost-effective than RFID readers. The data capturing is disadvantage is electronic, thus reducing the errors. Also very important to reduce the error, and also is a cost-effective system here, more cost-effective than RFID.